Hi students, all of you, good morning and good afternoon. In today's class, we are discussing the topic spectrum. What is meant by a spectrum? How can we define a spectrum? Spectrum means a group of electromagnetic radiations. A group of electromagnetic radiations having different types of frequencies and different types of wavelengths. Once again, spectrum is defined as a group of electromagnetic radiations having different frequencies and different wavelengths is called as a spectrum. All of you know the rainbow. Rainbow contains 7 colors, that is a VGR. Rainbow is also an example of a spectrum. And we can see the rainbow, that is visible. So that spectrum, rainbow is an example of a visible spectrum, right? So once again, what is meant by spectrum? A group of electromagnetic radiations with different frequencies and different wavelengths is called as a spectrum. And the spectrum is classified into two types. One is continuous spectrum. Second one is the discontinuous spectrum. As all of you know the VGR, in the VGR, one color immediately merges with other color. Between one color to other color, there is no gap. There is no gap means the colors are continuous with each other, continuously followed by each other. So VGR, that is the visible spectrum, is an example of continuous spectrum. So VGR is, we can observe the VGR in rainbow. So rainbow is an example of continuous spectrum. Yes, our chapter is atomic structure or structure of atom. That means we are going to discuss the arrangement of fundamental particles. What are the fundamental particles? Electrons, protons, neutrons are the fundamental particles of atom. We have to arrange them. That means we have to study about the structure of atom. To study the structure of atom. Atom is also a matter. When a matter is subjected to attacking of radiation, suppose if it is considered as an atom and some radiation is going to strike on the atom is going to absorb some part of the radiation. The remaining radiations are passed out. That remaining radiations which are passed out are passed through a slit, small hole, and then they are passed through a prism. When the remaining radiations which are passed through the prism, that radiations are going to get dispersed. Then the dispersed radiations are collected on a photographic film. We will get a spectrum. Which type of spectrum that is means? Discontinuous. Yes, coming to this point, the spectrums are of two types, continuous spectrums and discontinuous spectrums. So when we will get the discontinuous spectrum means? When we will get the discontinuous spectrum? When any matter is subjected to radiation, that matter is going to absorb some part of radiation. Remaining radiations are going to be transmitted. That transmitted radiations, when passed through a small slit and then passed through a prism, and due to dispersion of transmitted radiations through the prism, whenever they are collected on a photographic plate, we will see the spectrum, but that is not continuous because some part of the radiations, that means some frequencies of radiations are absorbed by the matter, remaining frequencies are transmitted. So that's why there is no continuity in the spectrum formed. Such type of spectrums are called as discontinuous spectrums. As coming to the point, the discontinuous spectrums are of again two types, line spectrum and band spectrum. Yes, I am saying the matter. Matter is made up of atoms. When the atoms are going to combine with each other, when the atoms are going to combine with each other, they are going to form the molecules. So a substance may contain atoms or the substance may contain molecules. Yes, you will get it out. Sir, which type of substances contain only atoms? Which type of substances contain molecules? Yes, all of you know the example, best example, diamond. Diamond. What, diamond contain which element? Text me your answer. Diamond contain which element? Diamond contain which element? Yes, very good. Carbon. As all of you know the arrangement of structure of diamond. Every carbon atom is tetrahedrally. This is the tetrahedral. Every carbon atom tetrahedrally surrounded. What is surrounded? What is surrounded? Carbon atoms are tetrahedrally surrounded in the diamond. So diamond is a matter. The diamond is a matter. That matter is only containing the diamond is containing the atoms. But there is no molecule. There is no molecule in the diamond. Only the atoms are bonded covalently with each other in a tetrahedron manner. About the structure of diamond, we will study in next chapter, that is chemical bonding. And of course, in one more chapter, that is fourth year group elements. Later, we will study about that one. Anyhow, my point is, I am taking a matter. The matter is composed of atoms. And sometimes the matter is going to contain the molecules. If the matter containing the atoms, if it is subjected to electromagnetic radiations, some part of the electromagnetic radiations are absorbed. Some part of the electromagnetic radiations are absorbed by the atoms. Remaining radiations are transmitted. That transmitted radiations when passed through a slit and then passed through a prism and then they are collected on a photographic film. Then we are going to get the spectrum. That spectrum is called as line spectrum. So line spectrum is formed by atoms. Once again, the line spectrum is formed by the atoms. So this bit will be asked in CET. Try to understand, try to remember. So line spectrum is formed by the atoms, whereas the substance containing the molecules, again you will get a doubt. Sir, what is the substance that is containing the molecules? Yes, just now you completed your dinner. Sorry, you completed your lunch. After the lunch completion, you drink the water. Water, it is a substance. It is containing hydrogen atoms and oxygen atoms, or it is containing water molecules. Water is a matter, whether it is containing hydrogen atoms and oxygen atoms individually, or it is containing hydrogen water molecules. Yes, water is containing the molecules. Of course, atoms are there. They are bonded with each other. We have to say water is containing molecules, whereas diamond is containing carbon atoms. So now, whenever water is taken in a solid state, for your understanding, for your easy understanding, I am taking the water in the solid state, that is ice is taken and electromagnetic radiations are passed through the ice. Ice is containing the molecules and the ice is going to, that is water molecules are going to absorb some part of the radiation. Remaining radiations are transmitted and they are passed through a slit and then they are passed through a prism. After dispersion, they are collected on a photographic film. Again, we will get a discontinuous spectrum, but that is an example of band spectrum. My dear students, we are not having about a band spectrum in the atomic structure. We are going to discuss only about a line spectrum, nothing but atomic spectrum. So atomic spectrum is an example of line spectrum. Again, the line spectrum is classified into two types. One is absorption spectrum. Second one is emission spectrum. So today we are going to discuss about these two. Absorption spectrum and emission spectrum. If we can understand these two, then we will go for the hydrogen spectrum, that is line spectrum of hydrogen atom. So to understand the topic, line spectrum of hydrogen atom, already I sent the PDF. To understand the line spectrum of hydrogen atom, we have to understand the two concepts. One is the line absorption spectrum. Second one is the line emission spectrum. Otherwise, it is also known as atomic absorption spectrum and atomic emission spectrum. So this is our today's topic. And yesterday already I shared a PDF. Now also I'm going to share the same PDF for your easy understanding. Yes, on the screen, you can see two spectrums. The first one is the emission spectrum. Second one is the absorption spectrum. I'm giving 2 minutes. Please watch the spectrum on the screen. Then I will explain. Some students said that yesterday, my class is a little bit fast. Of course, sometimes it will happen. No need to worry. Because every day the mood is not same. Every day the weather is not same. Every day the situations are not same. So whenever you are not able to understand my class, please inform to me. I will repeat the same class in the next class. Once watch the absorption spectrum and emission spectrum on the screen. Yes, okay, fine. Now, are you able to understand the class? Now in this class, are you able to understand? I am watching the text also. Yes, okay, fine, thank you. Yes, once watch the spectrum. I will give one more minute because I am taking the attendance screenshots. I can take attendance screenshot at any time of my class. I am not going to mention whether I am going to take the attendance at the starting of the class or at the middle of the class or at the end of the class. At any moment, I can take the attendance regarding my convenient. If you miss the attendance in my screenshots, I am not responsible. I am not responsible for your attendance. Yes, my dear students, coming to the board. Just a minute. Yes. Am I visible to you? Okay. And whether the spectrums are visible to you? Yes, both are visible. Okay, fine. Yes, if you see the second spectrum, that is the absorption spectrum. Just see the absorption spectrum. In the absorption spectrum, what you can observe? First of all, some white light source is taken. And that white light is passed through a sample. Here it was not mentioned whether the sample is going to contain the atoms or whether the sample is going to contain the molecules. It was not mentioned. Once again, here what is given? Absorbing sample is given. Sample is nothing but a substance. Here it is not mentioned whether the substance is going to contain the atoms or the substance is going to contain the molecules. Of course, it may contain either atoms or molecules. Some substance is taken and that is going to absorb some part of the radiations from the white light. The sample is going to absorb some part of the radiations from the white light. So this sample is said to be absorbing sample. How much electromagnetic radiations are absorbed? We don't know. Some part of the electromagnetic radiations are absorbed. And the remaining radiations which were unabsorbed, that are transmitted through a slit. Slit is nothing but a small hole. So the unabsorbed radiations from the absorbed sample are passed through a slit, and then that transmitted radiations are passed through a prism. This is a prism. So when the light is going to fall on the prism, yes, you know the physics terminology, dispersion of light. Due to dispersion of light, white light, when the white light is going to get dispersed, we can see different colors. So all these different colors containing electromagnetic radiations, that is the transmitted radiations, they are collected on a photographic film. This is a photographic film, film detector or photographic film. So on the photographic film, what is going to be recorded? That one is called as absorption spectrum. See here, absorption spectrum. So in the absorption spectrum, what you can observe between one color to another color, there is no immediate merge. Once again, between one color to another color, there is no immediate merge. We can find a separating line. Between one color to another color, we can see a separating line. Whereas in the VIBSER, we can't see the separating line between one color to another color. Once again, my statements. In the VIBSER, we can't find a separating line between one color to another color. Whereas here in the absorption spectrum, between one color to another color, we can identify a separating line. That means this spectrum is not a continuous spectrum. So this type of spectrum is called as discontinuous spectrum, and it is an example of absorption spectrum. So finally, we can say that it is a absorption discontinuous spectrum. Once again, it is the absorption discontinuous spectrum. And you can see one point given here, increasing wavelengths. All of you know, red color radiation, which is present on the right side, the red color radiation, which is present on the right side, red color radiations are having, red color radiations are going to have maximum wavelength and minimum frequency. Once again, the red color radiations are going to have maximum wavelength and minimum frequency. So increasing wavelengths. No need to remember this one. So this is all about formation of absorption spectrum. And we don't know whether this spectrum is formed by the atoms, and we don't know whether the spectrum is formed by the molecules. Anyhow, coming to the second one, A, small a. Once again, observe the small a. So in the small a, what is given first? Excited sample is given. Here, excited sample is given. In the first B, small b, once again, see the small b, absorbing sample is given. When the sample is going to absorb some part of the radiation, once again, when the sample is going to absorb some part of the radiation, radiation is nothing but energy. So when the energy is going to be absorbed by the sample containing atoms or the sample containing molecules, they are going to move from lower energy states to higher energy states. Once again, when the sample is going to absorb some part of the radiation, the sample containing atoms or the sample containing molecules, they are going to move from lower energy state to higher energy state. So the molecules or the atoms which are present in the higher energy state, they are called as excited atoms, or they are called as excited molecules. So when the substance is going to get excited, when the substance is going to absorb some part of the electromagnetic radiations, the atoms or the molecules are going to gain some additional energy, then the atoms or molecules are going to move from lower energy state to higher energy state. So this process, moving of atoms or molecules from lower energy state to higher energy state, this process is called as excitation of atoms or excitation of molecules. Yes, my dear students, actually the atoms or the molecules that are containing fundamental particles, that is electrons, protons, neutrons. And we are discussing about chemical reactions, chemistry. Chemistry deals with transfer of electrons only. So whether in the atoms or in the molecules, what are going to get excited? Only the electrons are going to get excited. Once again, only the electrons are going to get excited. But the protons and neutrons, they remain in the nucleus of the atom. So during the excitation process, only the electrons will move from lower energy state to higher energy state. So this process of moving of electrons from lower energy state to higher energy state, this process is called as excitation of electrons in an atom or excitation of electrons in a molecule. One point, see here. Suppose, see this one, this is a chalk piece. If this chalk piece is here, suppose I'm going to just drop this one. Chalk piece is going to move to the down and it is going to raise the earth by losing energy. Like that, the excited electrons are going to contain some absorbed radiations. That excited electrons are going to emit the absorbed radiations. During the emission of radiations, if the emitted radiations are collected on a photographic film, then the obtained spectrum is called as emission spectrum. So in the first diagram, you are seeing the first one, excited sample. How the sample is excited? How the sample is excited? By absorbing some part of electromagnetic radiation, the sample is get excited. Excitation means moving the electrons from lower energy states to higher energy states is the excitation. So first we are taking the excited sample. That excited sample is containing absorbed radiations. This is the main point you have to understand. The excited substance or the excited electrons or the excited atoms or the excited molecules, they are going to contain absorbed radiations. So in the excited state, the excited electrons are less stable, so they are going to emit the absorbed radiations. The emitted absorbed radiations are collected on a photographic film, then we will get the spectrum that is called as emission spectrum. So emission is release of energy, absorption is gaining of energy. Once again, emission means release of energy, absorption means gaining of energy. Both are opposite phenomenons. Emission and absorption are opposite phenomenons. So because of this opposite phenomenons, if we see any one spectrum, if we consider the absorption spectrum, and if it is taken in the mirror, if it is observed in the mirror, if the absorption spectrum is observed in the mirror, then we can see the emission spectrum. Otherwise, if the emission spectrum is observed in the mirror, we can see this light as absorption spectrum. So we can understand that emission spectrum and absorption spectrum are photographic mirror images. Once again, the emission spectrum and the absorption spectrum are the photographic mirror images. So this is all about formation of emission spectrums. And yes, you will get it out. Sir, whether this spectrum, of course you are saying this is a discontinuous spectrum, no doubt. Because we can see the separation. We can identify the separation between one color to another color. So we can say that these two spectrums are the discontinuous spectrums, no doubt. Now you will get it out. Whether this is an example of line spectrum or this is an example of band spectrum. Can anybody guess? Because already you are seeing on the screen. Can you guess whether these spectrums are line spectrums or band spectrums? Yes, waiting for your text. Wait a minute. Can you guess whether these two spectrums are line spectrums or band spectrums? Yes, correct. These are the line spectrums. These are the line spectrums. Of course, it was not given in our NCERT textbook about band spectrum. It was not given in our NCERT textbook about band spectrum. So no need to consider about this one. In our PO level syllabus, it is not there. So simply we can understand that the given two, one is the emission spectrum and the second one is the absorption spectrum. Both are the line spectrums. So finally, we can call them as line emission spectrum, line emission spectrum, and line absorption spectrum, right? Now, these two are also known as atomic emission spectrum and atomic absorption spectrum. Why? Because means we are not going to establish the structure of a molecule. We are not going to establish the structure of a molecule because the structure of the molecule can be established by different theories that will be studied in the chemical bonding. Here we are going to establish only the structure of atom. So establishing the structure of atom, and we are studying about the spectrums. These spectrums are indicating atomic spectrums. So atomic spectrums are the line spectrums. When the atom is going to absorb the radiation, then it is going to form the spectrum. That is line absorption spectrum or atomic absorption spectrum. When the excited atom is there, if it is going to emit absorbed radiation, then the obtained spectrum is called as line emission spectrum or atomic emission spectrum. Yes, text me whether it is understood. If it is understood, then I can move for the next topic, hydrogen spectrum, line spectrum of hydrogen, or simply it is called as hydrogen spectrum. Yes, yesterday some student texted the class is fast. Once again, the student is requested. Please text me. Yes, fine. Okay, what about the time? Till 10 minutes is there. Now I'm moving to the next topic. Based on this line emission spectrum and line absorption spectrum, we are going to establish the structure of hydrogen atom. Once again, we are going to establish the structure of hydrogen atom. To establish the establishing the structure of hydrogen atom is nothing but arrangement of fundamental particles in the hydrogen atom. Yes, hydrogen atom, atomic number is 1. Hydrogen atom, the atomic number is 1. And we know hydrogen can exist in 3 forms. H11, sorry, just a minute. Hydrogen existing in 3 isotopic forms. Already I explained the isotopes of hydrogen. H11, H12, H13. First one is called as protium. Second one is called as deuterium. Third one is called as tritium. Already I explained. All these three are called as isotopes of hydrogen. Isotopes of hydrogen. And already we know the number of electrons, protons and neutrons. I'm not going to go depth because the time is going to lag. So simply, in this H11, H12, H13, we are going to study about H11. Just tell me, in H11, how many number of electrons are there? How many number of protons are there? How many number of neutrons are there? Text me your answer. In H11, how many number of electrons are there? 1 electron, 1 proton. What about neutrons? What about neutrons? This number indicates atomic number, Z. Z value means atomic number. This number indicates mass number. Mass number is indicated by A. To calculate the number of neutrons, the formula is mass number minus atomic number, A minus Z, A value 1, Z value 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. So finally, we can understand that if we take any one hydrogen atom, I am not saying about H2. Hydrogen is a gas. I am not saying about the molecule. If I am going to take the hydrogen atom is going to contain 1 electron and 1 proton. Yes, coming to the Rutherford theory. According to Rutherford, the total mass of the atom is concentrated at the center of the atom. That center of the atom is called as nucleus. So nucleus is going to contain protons, because during the time of Rutherford, he does not know about the presence of neutrons, because neutrons are discovered by James Chadwick. So during the time of Rutherford, he don't know about the presence of neutrons. Just he arranged the total mass of the atom at the center of the atom, that is called as nucleus, and the nucleus is going to contain protons and arrangement of electrons. Now coming to the point, arrangement of electrons. Electrons are arranged around the nucleus in circular paths. And those circular paths are called as orbits. According to Rutherford, the electrons are going to revolve around the nucleus in fixed circular paths. That circular paths are called as orbits. But in the Rutherford theory, one drawback is there. The drawback is, when the charged particle is under acceleration, the charged particle should lose the energy. That means the electron should lose the energy continuously. So then the orbit should not be regular. The orbit should not be a circle. When the electron is going to lose the energy, the path of the electron must be spiral. Finally, at some time, the electron should jump into the nucleus. But this is not happening in the atoms. This was not explained by Rutherford. So, electron is not continuously losing energy. Electron is not continuously gaining energy. Losing energy is called as emission of energy. Gaining energy is called as absorption of energy. So electrons are neither going to emit energy continuously, nor going to absorb energy continuously. This was understood from the concept quantization of energies of electrons. Yesterday I started the topic quantization of energies of electrons. So to understand the quantization of energies of electrons, we have to know about the atomic spectrum of hydrogen. We have to understand the atomic spectrum of hydrogen, nothing but line spectrum of hydrogen. atomic spectrum of hydrogen. It is also known as line spectrum of hydrogen. Line spectrum of hydrogen, or simply it is called as atomic spectrum of hydrogen. Line spectrum of hydrogen, also known as atomic spectrum of hydrogen atom. No need to say again atom, because already in the starting we are saying that atomic spectrum. So atomic spectrum of hydrogen. Yes, on the screen. The time is very less. 4 minutes is there, of course. Just a minute. I am going to share the screen. Yes, once again on the screen you can see some data. Just observe the data. Already I sent the PDF. And my dear students, when you are watching the shared data in your mobile, first of all, please watch the videos like this by rotating your mobile, and try to use your two fingers on the mobile. You can enlarge the data like this. You can see the data in a large font. So this is the advantage during the sharing of the screen. So once observe the data given on the screen, line spectrum of hydrogen atom. I'm giving 2 minutes. Please observe carefully on the screen. Without coming to class daily, you can't understand the topic properly. So to understand any topic properly, you have to be regular to the online classes. You have to be regular to the online classes to understand the topics properly. By coming one day, by absenting other day, I think so, you are unable to understand topics. Then don't blame the lecturers. Blame yourself for your absence to the classes. Yes, so tomorrow I am going to explain the topic. Just I am going to give some brief introduction regarding this line spectrum of hydrogen. Yes, on the screen you are seeing some diagram. This diagram is called as line emission spectrum. Once again, line emission spectrum of hydrogen atom. I am saying emission. Emission means release of energy. Or emission of radiation. Already I said that when the atom is going to get excited, the atom itself is not going to get excited. The electrons in the atoms are going to get excited. In the excited state, the electrons are unstable. The excited electrons are coming back. The excited electrons are coming back from excited state to ground state. Ground state means the initial state of the electrons. The initial state of the electrons is called as ground state. So regarding this line emission spectrum of hydrogen atom, we will discuss tomorrow. And a small key point for tomorrow's class. If you see this diagram, you can observe colors. You can observe different colors at a particular zone. Are you observing that zone? What is the zone? Or what is the series? What is that series? Yes, this is the series, Balmer series. L is the silent, Balmer series. That is a visible region. So about this one, in the next class, we are going to discuss. Very, very, very important topic. Please don't get absent to the next class. Right? Just text me whether the class is understood or not. Whether I have to repeat it or not. Text me in the chat box. Please be stay online till the session is going to get end itself. And please follow the Zivit material for question and answers. by Sunday or Monday, I will upload the important questions, but don't